Yo, 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 what's up, guys? Welcome to Pokedex. So the regionals are coming, right? And I thought that I should be looking at more competitive decks than I previously have. So I thought maybe like this next 2 weeks, maybe three, if there are enough decks. I'm still not sure how many I'll be trying out, but I thought that I should, in the next few weeks, I should just build like the best decks in the that I believe are the best decks for the regionals and play them. The lists are going to be a little bit different than the lists on my previous videos, because, well, most of my videos are like brews or crazy ideas, and that means that I don't usually like to play meta cards. Imagine that I build a deck that is weak against Pyro, I just say screw it, if we get a Pyro deck we get it, I just want to test the idea. Well, with these decks, I will actually be building the list that I would play if I was going to play them in a big tournament. So I'm picturing like something like an 8 round tournament, something like that, with a top 8 afterwards. So this will be like the exact card list that I would play if the tournament was tomorrow, for example. So I'll talk a little bit about my first deck list. As you can see, this is the Speed Lugia deck, which is a plasma deck. Most of you guys already know this, I bet. I can talk a little bit about my card choices. And in more detail, just so you guys know, because that's what this is about, right? Talking about the matchups and the specific card choices. So I might take a little bit to explain everything, so let's go. So I have two Lugia EX, which is the main attacker of the deck. I don't think we need more. If we end up needing a third during the game, we have the Shadow Triad to get it back. Shadow Triad works like I've seen many people not playing this card, but I feel it's really, really good in this deck. It's like a dowsing machine, because it gets us pretty much everything. It gets us energy, it gets us another supporter in Colress, it gets us the ball, it gets us the stadium, it gets us the Colress machine, and it gets us any of our Pokemon. So I'm jumping a little bit ahead of myself in talking about the supporter Shadow Triad, but that's just because it's like, sometimes it's the third Lugia EX if we need it. Most of the times we won't. In a perfect world, we would only be attacking with one Lugia throughout the whole game, just because it takes a lot of energy commitment to attack with Plasma Gale. Of course, you draw three prizes, and that's what makes this deck really powerful. It's super, super speedy setting up. I mean, sometimes you can attack like on the first turn if your opponent goes first, because you have Colress Machine to accelerate. Colress Machine. So we're obviously playing four. It's the bread and butter of the deck. It's one of the most important cards. What makes this deck good is, I believe, Genesect decks like Virgin will be probably the most, like the deck to beat, I think. It's going to be the most overall consistent and powerful deck. And I think this deck actually has a decent matchup against it. Of course, it's nothing like 80-90% percentage win percentage, but I mean, if we get like 55%, that's perfect, because that's what you're going to get with the best decks ever. Of course, we also have game against pretty much any deck except for Pyro decks. And you'll see many people playing Plasma decks with Pyro decks. I chose not to, and you might ask why. I mean, if you're going to play in a big tournament, there's going to be Pyro decks, most definitely. Yeah, but let's pause and think about the Pyro decks for a bit. So you're playing in a big tournament. Let's say, I don't know, 100 people. How many people are playing Pyro decks in a 100 people tournament? Like 15? Of 100, that means that's 15%. So if there's 10 rounds, you would be playing 1.5 Pyro deck that's your expected percentage to play against pyro decks. So in an 8-round tournament, it's even less. So let's assume you're going to play at least one pyro deck. So that's one loss. I mean, I think it's totally acceptable. Most of the time, you won't even be playing pyro decks. And I'm going to be bold and say what I believe about the deck. I think decks based on pyro are not that good. And I think because of the pairings, if you don't get them like in the first three rounds, and you win those three rounds, you won't see them that much anymore. So the chances of seeing a pyro deck are lower as the day proceeds. I think they are like a super cool deck to, or people think they're a super cool deck to defeat Virgin, and they're not even that good against that particular matchup just because Virgin is so powerful and they're playing Bertix and stuff like that. So when I get to Virgin, I can talk more about that. But what I'm trying to say is I don't think we should play like a speed Lugia deck, which really, really, really relies on consistency and getting your cards out really, really fast. That's what makes it strong. And I don't think we should dilute it with Bertix or other cards that basically slow us down and put a stop to our quick gameplay. So we're just saying, okay, if you have a Pyro, it's okay. Maybe I can make you commit two EX Pokemon to the bench, or maybe you do that because you didn't have any other Pokemon to start with, and I can kill you with Lugia anyway. I've actually done that in here on Pokemon Trading Card Game Online. Of course, most people don't play Pyro decks as they should, and they drop Pokemon that they shouldn't as soon as they see the Team Plasma deck, but oh well, you might as well take advantage of the mistakes, right? So that's everything about Lugia and the matchups. I am playing one Snorlax, because this guy is not an EX Pokemon, which is pretty nice, because in the late game, when you're setting up your bench and your opponent is setting up his bench for a counter-attack battle, like he kills your guy, you kill his guy, like in one hit, Snorlax is really, really good hitting the opponent's Pokemon, like killing them in one turn. While if he's killed by them, they only take one prize. That's why this guy is here, basically. We're not planning on going with him on the start of the game, but it's a really nice non-EX attacker because it can one-hit KO anything, pretty much. We are playing two Thundras. This guy is excellent in the beginning of the game, and also to recharge a Lugia that was not that lost some energy. I think it's pretty self-explanatory why we're playing Thundras. We're playing Deoxys, a lot of them, because of the Pokemon power, which we really, really need. Because in the perfect world, obviously, we're Plasma Galing to one-hit KO the opponent's Pokemon. And with 120 damage, sometimes we have to add 60 damage on top. With a Muscle Band, that's an extra 20, but we're still 40 short. So that's where Deoxys comes in. Another card that comes in that strategy is Frozen City. We're playing three. Whenever any player attaches an energy from his or her hand to one of her Pokemon, excluding Team Plasma Pokemon, put damage counter on that Pokemon. So these are like the two extra damage counters that the opponent is going to take. I would play the lasers if I could, but lasers plus Burbank City Gym, that's at least six spots. Six spaces in the deck, six slots. And with this Frozen City, we can get those two precious points of damage with only three slots in the deck. What else can I talk about? I mean, I am playing Computer Search just because it's the fastest way to get a double colorless energy into our hand. This is really the kind of deck where we want to go fast early. I am playing two Starling Megaphone because while Garbodor doesn't outright kill us, I mean, the deck still works, we can still Plasma Gale for 120, but it does slow us down a lot. It prevents us from one-hit KOing. So we are playing two of those. And that's it. Another thing I should talk about. I'm playing 2N only, because this deck draws prizes so quickly that I feel N is not that good. I mean, it is if the opponent starts winning, and it is in the early game, because it's like it refills our hand. But I'm only playing two because of that. I'm playing a lot of Colress instead. So hopefully you can fill our bench before we start needing to draw cards. I am playing two Lysander just because it helps us to, even against like a Pyro deck, we can catch him off guard and hit the bench guys with Lugia and get extra prizes and maybe win that way. And that's it. Let's go play some matches. Okay. Let's see what we're playing against. Maybe the other plasma deck like Hurum EX. Yeah, it seems our opponent is playing Hurum. I'm saying Hurum because I saw the color indicators down there. Yes, I want to draw a card. Thank you. Right now, I don't have any lightning energy to drop on Thundurus, so I think I'll let him get hit. And I'll try to set up my Lugia as fast as I can. Huh, he's playing Eevee as well. Okay. Wonder what that means. So he ends this. And I'm just hoping my opponent plays a lot of Pokemon because I want the extra. Okay, so he plays a stadium, which makes us not be able to play a stadium. But I'm not going to take damage from the stadium, and neither is my opponent. So there's that. Another problem with this deck is you have to. Okay, so I only have one Lugia in the deck. Although my Deoxys are there. You really have... This is a deck that really benefits from you memorizing everything that's in the deck, like the first time you look at it. Of course, I'm playing online, and I'm talking as I speak, which slows my thinking down. I'm talking as I speak. I'm sorry. I'm talking as I think, which basically stops my thinking, slows it down. And the cards are harder to manipulate, so I might make mistakes regarding that, but I'm just trying to count my plasma energy. I think I have 3 in my deck, yeah, and I have 3 Colress Machine as well, so we'll keep that in mind, because we will need that. Okay, so I'm sorry, I'm sorry, opponent, for taking so long, but I'm not a fan of discarding this. Or shuffling this escape rope back, but yeah, I just think I'm going to take let the Thundurus take a hit. Yeah, and we We did draw the switch, so there's that. Opponent is going for the 60 damage attack on our Thundurus. Can deal 50 on the way back. He's also weakening our guy. I'm not sure. Okay, if I had a switch, I can draw into one with N. If I had a switch, I could go with Lugia straight away to draw two prizes and only get 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 120 damage next turn. If he drops a Muscle Band, he kills us with his Deoxys. Yeah, that doesn't sound good, does it? So I think I'm just going to bite the bullet and attack with Thundurus. I'm going to shuffle, though. So I think the plan is the same, right? I have to keep this Colress machine in hand. I still have 2 energy in my deck for it, so I won't be drawing it, which is nice. I'm keeping it in my hand because I might be forced to go with Deoxys to kill his Deoxys. I'm just being careful because maybe I won't be able to hit with Lugia like more than once anyways. Let's see how this plays out. Of course, he's happily eating my Lugia that's sitting on the bench. So right now, if I go with Lugia, he immediately kills it. So that's not a good idea. I can try to find a way to kill. Okay, so this will grab another energy. Now I'm going to drop it here. So is this thing going here? Because I want to chorus. And I do get the third deoxys, the fourth deoxys, which is great because now I can kill Iscurium in one hit. I have the chorus machine in hand, which is useless. But if he ends me, do I want to have it? Yes, I do. So I'll keep it there. Yep. Raiden Knuckle. Let's see how my opponent chooses. Probably with Kirim. Yeah. This will force me, I think, to go with Lugia. And he will kill it with Thunderous pretty easily. He doesn't even have to bring the his Deoxys back. This is a weird matchup that I haven't ever played before, so it's actually pretty nice. So I can deal... Huh. Can use my Lugia. So it's 20... It's 140 right now. I think I'm going with Lugia because I can Colress. I can Lysander, I mean. I wouldn't be killing anything. I mean, I need a muscle band anyway, so... Oh boy. What can I do? Let me think what my... Let me think about what my plan will be. So, this guy hits for 160. I needed an extra 10 to kill his Thunderous, and I can't Lysander this turn, so that's out of the question. Can switch back into my Deoxys, but then he kills my Deoxys with this. I think I'm going to grab another Thunderous because that's all I can do right now. I wish I also had space for Snorlax because... Huh, if I let my Lugia die, would that be that bad? I would be drawing two prizes now. He would be drawing two as well. And I would be able to go with Snorlax afterwards. So maybe that's the way to go. I'll try it out. Yeah, okay. I'll also play this because might as well now. Okay, so Plasma Gale. Let's go. I'm giving him my Lugia. Maybe this is totally wrong, but I feel like if I can get the Snorlax going, it's going to be hit me like for a million damage. Go Thunderous, you beautiful bastard. So there's the Team Plasma Ball, so I don't even have to spend anything on that. How much HP does this guy have? So it's 90. 50, I can kill it this turn. That's actually pretty nice. Because that means no more free retreat for his Pokemon. Do I want to do that? Yes. Okay. Let's see how this works out. Maybe I misplayed somewhere along the line, but can never be sure, right? This is where an N would actually be pretty nice, because I would be happy just N-ing my opponent and getting my Snorlax ready for the fight. I mean, Snorlax is getting scary, though. Of course, my opponent also has a non-EX attacker in Kyurem. Maybe he's going... Yeah, he's going with it right now. And this will force me... This puts us in a really bad position, right? He can kill us next turn if he has an extra energy. And if he doesn't, he can deal 80 damage. Which doesn't kill us at all, so I think I have to do that. I think I have to Because I can't go with Deoxys. I can switch into another Deoxys. Yeah, maybe. Do I have a switch in my deck? But then I have to draw the double colorless MG, which I most likely will because I haven't seen them. Resume. Okay, so this energy goes here. I'm going to play a switch into this guy. Let him take a hit. Okay, oh, should have looked into my deck. Okay, doesn't matter now. Now this stuff shows up. So this will make my opponent have a harder time. Now I almost feel like I want to go with no, it still needs an energy, it's all the same, so. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 90, 120, no, it's the same, man. Come on. I do have a double colorless for next turn, so yeah. I have to end the turn right there. This is a hard game. Sorry, I'm taking a little bit longer to think about stuff. Because I'm trying to be the best player I can. So now he can retreat at will, basically. But I will be able to one-hit KO anything he plays, so yeah. His best bet is just attacking with Deoxys. Do I kill his Deoxys now? Is Kyurem now? I think I do. He will kill it with Deoxys if he has the energy. But I can kill his Deoxys right away, so I think that's our best bet. Not going to play any supporter because, or am I? No, I'll keep them because in case he ends us. Okay, 220. There's the Lugia. I think it's too late for it. Yes, free retreat with this guy. That's why. Put it in front. Let's see if my opponent has the energy to kill our guy and if it matters at all. So he plays it on Thundurus because I won't be able to kill this. Oh yeah, I will because if he doesn't kill my Snorlax. I mean, if he has a Lysander. Oh, okay, so we won. I think it was the right call to go with Snorlax. As you see, that's why the guy is here. Textbook Snorlax performance. I mean, we still have time for another match if we can. So Snorlax pretty nice in that match, being the non-EX attacker that we needed, being able to one-hit KO anything my opponent had, and the only thing he could do to kill it was maybe use the Deoxys if he had a Plasma Energy, and if he did, I would kill him with my Deoxys. The only thing my opponent could have done was play Lysander and kill one of our EX Pokemon, but since he couldn't, I won. Maybe we're going to play a Pyro deck now. My opponent has both Psychic and Fire Energy. And he's going to go first. I like to go with Thundurus. That's pretty nice. I'll play this guy. Not Snorlax for now. Maybe we'll need the extra card. Let's see what our opponent is playing. Uh-huh. So it's the Pyro deck. Let's see how things. If I were my opponent, I wouldn't play any other EX Pokemon. And he does. Okay. This means we have enough EX Pokemon to kill him with Lugia. Like, if we kill both these guys with Lugia, we are set, we are good to go. So I'm not sure if I would have done that if I were my opponent. Let me think about my life for a little bit so I can get support, a decent supporter this turn, and I think that's the plan. And I can let this energy go. If I'm confident, I'll draw another, which I am not. Let's see our deck first. Yeah. So I think we're going to get a Juniper. We have 1, 2, 3 Plasma Energy, 1 Deoxys, 2 Deoxys, 2 Colorless Machine, 1 Lugia, 3 Deoxys. Two Lugias, three colorless machines. That's cool, okay. One, two. The third energy is here, so maybe I'll... Yeah, I won't bet that I'll draw the other energy. I'm just going for Deoxys this turn. I can play Lugia afterwards if I want to. I'll go for trying to do as much as I can with my Thundras. We are set for a nice Chorus next turn. My opponent most definitely has a Pyroar and a Supporter. Yeah, Sycamore. The way he played, screamed. So Pyroar has 140, which basically doesn't matter at all against us. It just takes our stadium out of there. I think he made a big mistake playing the Mewtwo EX into the bench. And I think I'll try to exploit that. Not sure I'll be able to do that perfectly. Can we do 110 damage with Mewtwo EX? I don't think we can. With Thundras EX, that's what I meant. I think I'll keep the Muscle Band in my deck. Yes. Okay. So we do get a Lugia. And I'm going for it. I won't be playing another Thundras because I need the space in my bench for the Deoxys. So I might as well draw cards now. Okay, so we get a Colress Machine, which is super, super nice. I can attack with Lugia EX. I don't even know if I want to kill his Charizard, you know? Because if we attack with Lugia, we draw three prizes, and that's where it's at, right? I mean, I think I'll retreat into Lugia next turn, kill his Charizard, and then trying to retreat and get Lugia ready again to kill his Mewtwo EX. That's, I think, the way we will win this game. It will take longer than I was hoping the game would take. The second game with Dick. I know I spent a lot of time explaining the deck. Ooh, Pokemon Catcher. Okay, fails. Nice. I don't know what my opponent would have dragged into play. Maybe the Lugia to get a 60 damage hit. Okay, so he hides his Charizard, which is fine by me. I mean, it gives us more time to set up our stuff on the bench. Yeah, I want to go with Lugia twice, so I won't even play any energy. Okay, so we have the second plasma in our hand, but I want to spend the Colorless Machine here. Okay, get this here. And now we're subject to drawing into the Lysanders, basically. I didn't check how many I have in my deck, but that's all I can do right now. So yeah. My opponent doesn't seem to have the fire energy he needs as well, so maybe we have enough time to do everything. Okay, so it has have the double colorless energy. Boy, we really need that. Need that Lysander to win. I am going to play this. No, I won't. He kills us with Mewtwo in one hit. It doesn't really matter, does it? Okay, so. My opponent has pretty much everything he needs. Oh yeah. Oh, he's killing Thundras. Okay, I'm cool with that. Draw your two prizes. That also makes me happier about playing an N if I have one. Oh man, he has another Pyroar. That sucks. If he didn't, I would be able to kill his dude. But I think I'll play the escape rope anyways, because He will go with a Pyroar that only has one energy, so that might give us more time. Okay. End turn. Yeah, this is a waiting game. My opponent gave us an opening, though. I just need to draw supporters. Another Litley, okay. He has everything you will ever need. Oof. I'm trying to make the most out of the energy I have, of the Pokemon I have. I don't want to give him, like, to let him kill a Deoxys, because I might need it to pump the damage on the Lugia. Okay, so we can get the Lysander next turn, but that's not enough at all. So I think we have to go for another supporter, like an N. And we'll also fill up his hand, so N is not the best thing to get. We do have one Lysander, two Lysander left. That's nice. We don't have any more Colress, though, so we have to go with a Sycamore. Just because we have to find more ways to get the Lysanders, which sucks. Yeah, so I should have played the energy to be able to retreat next turn. Although maybe I just let the Deoxys die, right? Thunderous, yeah, since Deoxys is going to die anyways. Okay. Play this here as well. Stadium. To hurt this guy. And I can get the extra Deoxys. And still no Lysander in our hand. Okay. Whew, this is a hard game, I'm tired. Okay. Oh, two Lysanders and a Deoxys. Yeah, that's perfect. And we have the Thunderous to recharge. I'm going for the Charizard, like, as fast as I can. Okay. Lugia it is. This guy. There he goes. I won't even play the Muscle Band, because I want to scare my to make my opponent think I don't have it. I don't need it, yeah. For now, at least. So, Plasma Gale, 150, 3 prizes. Hopefully, my opponent doesn't end us, and we can win straight away. Whew! It's a really tiring game.